Hello everyone and welcome to MBAP. We are going to discuss the CMAT 2021 paper which was there today. In this video, I'm going to do complete analysis. Okay, the main point is going to be the slot-wise comparison, slot 1 versus slot 2, because a lot of students from slot 2 are actually complaining, saying that certain things were not in their favor in slot 2. Certain goof-up things happened, okay, like the time slot, okay, which was for the external, the new section, okay, that time slot was not there. So definitely a lot of goof-up out there, okay, but if you see in slot number 1 also, there were certain questions which were wrong. Now this usually happens, okay, this kind of activities usually happens in CMAT or CET kind of exam. So I'm going to discuss all of that in detail, okay, bringing out the college-wise specific cutoffs that you can expect. As I was telling you, that logic is going to be the jackpot, okay, for CMAT. That was the case this time also, and GK, like every year, it was the deciding factor. So in certain ways, okay, very much then the paper was very much like what it was last year. But yes, certain areas, okay, in terms of RCs and all that, okay, which changed this year. So we're going to discuss all of that in detail. So let's go ahead. Okay, a quick reminder, okay, to follow us on YouTube and Instagram. You can subscribe to our channel, okay, so that you get regular updates. Now, if I go with the first section, which is cons that I pick up, okay, now slot 1, slot 2, these are roughly the number of questions, okay, it's not that these are exact ones, okay, these are roughly the questions that we remember from the students, okay, who gave this exam. One of our faculties also gave our exam. So from the numbers, okay, which different people have given up, okay, this is what we come up with. Now, overall, if you ask me about cons section, how was it? Okay, cons section was on, you can say, a moderate side, okay, people who are good with cons preparation, they would definitely found it easy, but people who are not good with cons, okay, they found it tough as well. Okay, so overall, from the CMAT level of cons, if I say, it was a moderate kind of a paper. Okay, now if you see, there was not much of difference in terms of the expectation, because arithmetic was expected to be more number of questions. So yes, that was more. Okay, if you see, okay, close to around 10 to 12 questions were there on arithmetic from different areas. Okay, that we had algebra was 4 to 5 questions. Okay, equation were there, higher order equations were there, geometry, and in fact mensuration was also there. Okay, so geometry, mensuration, one question I think was there in both the areas. Here you see that numbers in slot number 2 was only one question. Okay, over here it was 5 questions. Okay, in slot number 1 there were 5 questions on that. So overall, not much of a surprise element from the distribution of the question. Okay, not much of a surprise element, but yeah, in terms of difficulty level, slightly higher than what it was last year. Okay, that means over here, okay, people with not much of preparation of cons, or rather not very good at cons, they felt the heat of this section. Okay, and that's why if you ask me, okay, ideally how much 22 questions, okay, for people who are very, very good, okay, they would have easily got up to 22 to 23 right. However, in general, other students, okay, who are not very good with cons, okay, for them it would be somewhere around 18 to 19 questions, okay, that would have gone right. Okay, so this is about cons section. Okay, coming to the next, which is logic. Now, logic is a jackpot. I love logic of CMAT, because look at the topics. Okay, like just like every year. Okay, look at the topics. Okay, like the very easy ones. There were certain miscellaneous, I mean, things. Okay, which was you had questions on visual reasoning and all of that. Okay, but understand. Okay, there were certain things in slot number 2 which was not there. Like say for example, syllogisms were not there. Okay, critical reasoning was not much. Okay, arrangement based puzzles were there. Okay, but only 1 or 2 questions. Okay, coding, decoding. Otherwise, it was very much similar. Only these two things were not there. Otherwise, logic was the jackpot. It was, I would say, on a very easy side. Okay, overall. And here I would not be surprised if anyone gets 25 on 25. Okay, I think. Other than that, people with not much of preparation, they would have got around 20 to 21. Okay, questions are right. So here logic, okay, you can definitely pick up more marks. Okay, I told you in my sectional analysis that you should give 50 minutes to this section. Okay, because here the questions are going to be easy, and this is going to be the score booster section. And that proved to be today, okay, when we are talking about the analysis of it. Now, coming to verbal section, okay, the verbal 2021, okay, paper verbal, if you talk about here, okay, now slot 2 people were not happy with this, okay, because over here, okay, that you see, or rather slot 1 people had more number of RCs, okay, slot 2 had less number of RCs. The challenge was this, that the FIBs were there, okay, more for slot number two. Now, when FIBs were there, okay, people have to be good with vocabulary. If you don't know those words, okay, those areas, okay, you could not do anything. So that is where, okay, some of the people are complaining about slot twos, are that if you would have got more RCs probably by reading the passage, you would have answered it. But if you ask me, okay, the personality education, the RCs were, if you had a knack to read those kind of articles, then good. If not, okay, then you would have definitely faced challenge. Other than that, grammar, okay, pretty much same. Okay, parajumbles usually comes less only. In slot number two, there was no parajumbles. Okay, but yes, this actually changed a lot of things for the verbal section of slot two people. Okay, otherwise, plain vocabulary questions were not there here. Okay, because they had given so many FIBs. Okay, over here, you have two questions. So this is one area that if you see last year, the CMAT paper had less of RCs. This year, they increased it. But last to last year, I remember the RCs were more. So you can't say, okay, the number of RC questions have always been fluctuated between 5 to 12. Okay, and that is the case. This time also, it happened with one slot to another slot. Now, GK was definitely difficult this time. Okay, I would not say that it was easy. It was definitely above moderate level or difficult, okay, that you can say. With more questions coming on static, okay, and almost equal number for current affairs. But here in slot number two, we had more of static and less of current affairs. Pretty much in terms of the expectation, okay, usually the static is more always. Okay, so that's why we also had shared all those PDFs, okay, for you to prepare. But if you look at the kind of questions, some of the questions are really tricky. For example, there's a question on Khelo India. Okay, now Khelo India game has got 18 games, okay, in that, and the question was asking that which among these is not a part of Khelo India. Now the names, okay, are such traditional names, okay, which are there, so obviously it becomes difficult to know that which, like, you should know all the 18. That's really a task to know, okay, and those kind of questions, okay, some questions were coming were there on some previous history, okay, some war events were there. So definitely GK was difficult, okay. And I think anyone who is getting 10 questions right would be definitely a very, very good thing to do. Okay, that means a 40 score would be a very, very good score here. Okay, other than that, I think most of the people might end up around 6 to 7 questions, okay, getting right, okay, in this particular section. That's why I'm saying that GK is definitely going to be the deciding factor. Now, coming to the expected percentile, okay, you see this score, okay, and the percentile, okay, you will see that last year, this was slightly more than this, okay, around 15 questions or more than this. So we are expecting that the score might come down because of the very, very tough GK that had come, and that you see that the cons level had gone up, okay, with these two things, okay, and the mistakes. I don't know whether because of the mistakes in the paper, how the normalization is going to happen, okay, but using these scores, okay, you definitely see this, the scores have come down slightly. Last year, okay, this was around 330 where I had put a 99.5 percentile. This time it has come down to around 310 that I'm expecting. Okay, so this is the percentile breakup, okay, for different percentiles, okay, the top four percentiles that we show like this. Okay, so this is the score. Now if you look at the expected college cutoffs, okay, because these are the prominent colleges, okay, that accept CMAT score, the best being JBIMS. Okay, now JBIMS is at 99.9 percentile. Okay, if you see here, okay, I'm expecting it to go around 330. Okay, around 330 for that. Okay, for a 99.9 percentile. Okay, Sydenham is going to be slightly less like this. Okay, and then if you come down, okay, because Great Lakes, okay, GIM and KJ Sumer, they usually have around 97 to 98 percentile is their cutoff. Okay, so expecting somewhere around this. Okay, even if it might go higher, it might be only 260, not more than that. That means if you have scored around 250, 260, you should definitely be expecting calls from these. Okay, as such, the calls are done. And you can update the scores, and then those scores is going to be considered for the final selection. Wellinker, okay, usually has got a percentile cutoff or 90 percentile, or rather, in fact, for the other courses that we see, 80 percentile. So if you talk about 80 percentile, definitely here, okay, this might even go less than this for that matter. But if you have more than 90 percentile, your chances of converting Wellinker increases a lot. Okay, so people getting a 150 score, I think you might still get a Wellinker call, but the conversion chances increases fairly when you have a 90 percentile plus. Okay, that means a score of around 190 would definitely increase your chances of converting Wellinker. So people who were looking at Wellinker specifically through CMAT, okay, understand that if you guys are expecting somewhere around this score, you should be expecting the call. Okay, and for you should be starting your preparation for the next round of selection process. I think that's all that I had. Okay, I hope you guys and like the entire analysis. Okay, please click on the like button and share it with your friends. Okay, with regards to the expected college cutoffs, okay, especially that I have shared in this video. All the best.